There's only one Everglades in the world. We're doing this for our kids, you know, honestly.
Heart of the Everglades in Florida. The alligator and the flamingo bird are in their true element. But after more than a century of draining the land, the fresh water flows are damaged. To recreate the flows, a massive federal restoration plan is carried out, spanning over 30 years and costing over $16.5 billion.
And that is a system of 68 specific projects scattered throughout Central and South Florida. It's about sustainability. It's making sure that we're going to have enough water for residential use, for commercial and agricultural use, and enough water for the environment.
One important part of this extensive project is the build of the C43 water reservoir. When finished, the two-celled above-ground reservoir will be close to the size of Manhattan.
The project is basically an area where there is a perimeter embankment of 90 miles where we're going to catch water coming from the Caloosahatchee River during the period of flooding. In this way, we are going to try to avoid the fresh water of the river is going directly to the estuary, mixing with the salt water and creating phenomena which are not good for the environment.
The reservoir will be able to hold a breathtaking 200 billion liters of fresh water. Right now, 42 Volvo machines are working the soil.
Talking about different materials, at the end of the works, we're going to move 20 million cubic yards of material.
We started in 1845 when Florida became a state. The federal government gifted to the state of Florida all of the wetlands with the requirement that they be drained. All this ditching and draining has changed the ecology. So at that point, the state of Florida said, we need to change things. What we hope to see when the project is completed is we get the proper salinity in the estuary and the proper water quality.
With the C43 water reservoir and the other projects connected to the big restoration plan, the future for the whole state of Florida looks brighter than ever before.
It's a one-of-a-kind ecosystem, and it's one of the biggest restoration projects in the world right now. The hope is that we can figure this out, replumb the Everglades, get the water where it needs to be, when it needs to be there, to the point where everyone can enjoy what I had and what our forefathers had before us.